best man speech by Dan.
So, hello, good evening, everyone. And before we get going today, I would like to thank both the Hickey family, the Nutty family, and everyone who was involved to make today possible. It was a really, really gorgeous afternoon. I know we surely have a very memorable evening ahead of us. So, for those of you that don't know me, my name's Danny Brennan. And, James and I have been very close friends and actually roommates for the better part of 10 years. And although, you know, James and I have been very, very close friends for years now, you don't have to spend too much time in the room to know that he's oftentimes the life of the party, and certainly enjoys having a good time and makes everyone around him have a great time with him. And to put a little context around how James and I first met, we were first sophomores at the University of Dayton, and during our first week back in class, which we were not taking so seriously, we actually met at a pool party with a bunch of others of our friends, and we had a lot of mutual friends but hadn't known one another at this point. And to paint this picture for you of James and my first introduction to him, he comes rolling up to this party with a big blonde wig on, sort of like Dog the Bounty Hunter, with a bandana tied around his head, and a tank top, and the real cherry on top was he had cut a pair of jean shorts that looked quite a bit like a pair of Daisy Dukes. So, now Mrs. Hickey, I do want to applaud your bravery for finally allowing your son James to dress himself at age 20. And but in fairness to him, there was quite a bit going on that day, and everyone had some kind of goofy get-ups, and my swim trunks were only a few threads away from being called a Speedo. So now that everyone has this very lovely visual inside your heads, you now know how the foundation of which our friendship was formed. And so fast forward a few years, and James and I graduate, and we both had moved back to the Chicago area where I'm originally from, and James is, being from Kentucky, and wanted to keep the good times going. We had originally lived in my parents' basement before moving out to Wrigleyville and Lincoln Park, and every weekend we were spent together going out, having a good time, catching games, and spending money we really didn't have at all at the time. And then eventually one night came around where it was a night James had been sweating a little bit and dreading, but it was the night where he finally had to introduce the girl he's been seeing to the rest of his guy friends, which was very clear. He had a little apprehension towards, scared that we were going to send her running for the hills, but clearly that's not how the story ends. And so James invited myself and fewer friends to Alicia's home for a party that evening with a not-so-secret agenda of finally meeting the girl he's been seeing. And I come in, and I'm expecting business as usual for James and I. And that's, having a good time, making each other laugh. But, this night was very different. And he was clearly all eyes on Alicia. And although it was my first time meeting her, I knew right then and there she had James totally wrapped around her finger, and knew that this day would soon be coming. And since then, Alicia has taught James many, many things, and most importantly, it's she's further brought out that loving, generous, and very funny side he has, and now as an excellent husband that I know he will be. And sort of wrapping things up here, I do want to congratulate the Hickey family. You have another, beautiful, smart, intelligent daughter to your already very extensive collection that you already have today. And to the Nutty family, in nautical terms, you are officially in the eye of Hurricane Hickey. But, in serious, you do have a guy who is totally head over heels for your daughter, and I know will be absolutely a perfect husband. And to my dear friends, James and Alicia, I couldn't be more honored to play a small part in your big day. It has been an absolute blast, and I, of course, will always be there for you both. And God forbid you have to deal with any hardships, like the Patriots only make it to the AFC Championship, or the Kentucky Wildcats only having to play with 3 first-round draft picks, or USC just having to sell for another Rose Bowl. I will be there for you both. So, everyone, please raise your glass and cheers to a lifetime of love and happiness. Thank you very much.